So today I'm going to show you how to make electrolyte capacitor symbol and footprint in your integrated library. So if you have seen my previous videos, then last time, I mean for Fujitsu Marker, I created this library which is called example SMD library, and for the symbol and for the footprint. So I'm not going to create it again, new library. What I can do, I can add the new component in this library. So go to this schematic library. So here that it looks like, and then I will copy this, paste, and change the name for this. Call it let's say it's a cap, or yeah, cap minus 47 micro, yeah, 35 volt, and let's call it ELCO. And here designator, I would like to say C. Comment, you can choose the comment here. You can say okay, I want here value, and then you can add here the parameter. For example, can go here add the parameter which is called here value, and then you can write here for example 47 micro, and then the, if you want, you can also write like 35 volt, but I'm not going to write 47 microfarad is enough for me. And you can also add the rest of the parameter if you want. So that's all, and then I'm going to delete this symbol here and also remove this Fujitsu marker footprint. So now at the moment I'm having a grid of 2.54. You can change it if you want. Let's say I want 1 millimeter is enough for me. If your schematics are really big, so you can choose grid 1 millimeter. For that, what you have to do, you have to just click on the G, and then it will change automatically. As you can see here, as I'm pressing G, which means grid, and then it's changing from 1 to 2.5 to 5, and then again to 1. So I will set for 1 millimeter, and then go place a pin. So you have to place here a pin. Say here one pin is 1, pin number 1, and pin number 2. We will change that later on. Let's say designator, this is my pin number 1, and yeah, so, and then this is my, you can with the space bar you can shift. First thing is that okay, here I don't want the name. You can leave the name as it is. Designator you can switch off, and here you can switch off the designator. Let the name be there and change it to 2, like that. Then click on this, go to properties, say how much your length you want. I think for me, let's say 1 millimeter. Okay, still small, 2 millimeter, so that's look good. So this is my origin, and then again I will go here and pin length, I will change it to 2 millimeter. It looks good for me. And sorry, I think it should be like this, pin number 2, and you can, so that it should be able to connect. Yeah, and here also like that. So next thing is that you can go to place, then in place you have to choose the line, and then I will copy this, choose this, paste, think it's look good, bring it to here. Let me change the color to blue, this one also to blue, looks good. Yeah, and I think this is very big. Well, so not bad. And what I would like to do here is that for in electrolytic capacitor you have to make the signs, which one is positive and which one is negative. So I am going to put here, for example, this is my plus. I can copy and then later on change the color. So I think this is the minimum what you need is small. For example, if I'm going for so what I will do, I will bring this here and say copy. You don't need to copy this, you can extend this, and you can extend this here like that, and change the color again to blue. You can choose the color as you want, but I like the blue, so that's why I'm taking it as a blue. Here you can also change it to 1.5, I think. Yeah, and this one also to -1.5 millimeter. Sorry, this one also 1.5, and this one also to -1.5 millimeter. So I think it looks good. Yeah, and this one also. So what you can do here, you can change the length. So we wanted to reduce this size, so you can go to say it's 2. Okay, 2 is too much, so 1.5, and then instead of 3 I would like to say 2.5, and same here you can change it from 1 to say -1.5, and from 3 to 2.5, so it looks better. So that's how you can change the length. Now you can shift the symbol more closer toward the pin. So yeah, that's how you can make the symbol. So here what we can do, I mean, it's good, but I will do one more modification here. Yeah, that looks a bit better. So you can copy this minus sign and then put here, so that looks good for me. And then we can maybe extend this bit, so now it looks perfect for me. Yeah, so we are done with the symbol, and now we can go for the footprint. So this is the symbol footprint which I made for Fujitsu marker last time. PCB library, I will copy this and say okay, and then we will change it to, for example, let's say I'm having a case of D type. So it's called D case. You can see that case, there are different kind of cases. Here I will delete all these things. So now for the D case, I will, as you can see here, for the D case, this is the size of the electrolyte capacitor, and for D case, here is the standard size where you can see that distance between the two positive and negative pin is 1.8, and its length is, the length of the pad is, suggested pad is 3.2 and width is 1.6. So from the center they are saying that it's 1.8 millimeter. So go to place and then pad, choose the pad. We are not going to put in the center. Okay, let's put it in the at the center and then bring it to the top layer. So now change the shape. It's a say rectangular with rounded rectangular. That looks more, that looks better. And then we can change this x is 1.6 millimeter and epsilon is 3.2 millimeter, and yeah, corner radius I took it 50%. You can choose maybe 30, 20 as you wish. So that's how it's look like. For example, if I will change to the 20, yeah, so let it be 20 here, and then I will copy this and paste again one time. So that's how it looks like. And then let me shift it from the center. Say the distance between the two pad is, for D type case, is 1.8. So 0.9 from the center this side and 0.9 from the other side. Control M and then it will give you the distance. So it's 1.3. Let me shift it toward the center. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I hope so that now it's 0.9. Yeah, so it's now 0.9. Then I will also bring this to here. So let me check. 0.7. So again, I have to push two times outside. So let me measure this 0.9. Yeah, you can measure the distance, any distance, using Control M. Now we have to import the 3D body for this, the 3D step model, which we will get from the website.
So 3D step model for the electrolyte D case capacitor, I downloaded from the electronic supplier website, which is called Mouser. I will provide you the link in the description, so you can also download. This is the step model for D case, and I have already downloaded and saved it, and I will import it in my footprint. So go to place, then choose 3D body and choose the step model.
So let me place it at the center, and we have to change here the pin number. Let's say this is my pin number 1, sorry, and this is my pin number 2, which means that pin number 1 is positive, 2 is negative, and in 3D mode, let me go to the 3D mode, that's how it looks like. And yeah, I think the pins are small in this case. Let me shift this to this side. Okay, yeah, so I think, yeah. We have to make the outer surface of the capacitors. So for that, what we can do, you can go to the top overlay, then place line. You can select here line. And then we will start so let me change the again the grid 0.02 so that we can grab the so now sorry, we can start from here, go till here, then here, double click, and then again you can start here. Just make these lines and then later on we can adjust that, that's not a problem. So now it looks good.
I placed the 3D strip wrong here. I have to rotate it 180 degrees. And I have to correct the lines. The line should overlay line. I mean, should match with the outer line of the capacitor case. So I corrected the outer line of the D case, and we are done with the footprint. And now we have to integrate this footprint with the symbol in integrated library. So we are done with the footprint and symbol, and integration you can do yourself, or you can watch my previous video in which I did integration for Fujitsu marker. Yeah, and thank you very much. If you like the video, then please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thanks.